Welcome to the HinduVerse, where information and stories on various characters and events of Hindu mythology are presented to you. Today, let me tell you about Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva is one of the major gods in Hindu mythology. He has a lot of importance in Hinduism due to his direct involvement in the creation, maintenance, and destruction of the universe. He is known by various names, some of which are Mahadeva, Mahayogi, Pashupati, Nataraja, Vairava, Vishwanath, Baba, Bholenath, and Shankar. Lord Shiva is perhaps the most complex god among all Hindu deities and one of the most powerful as well. Shiva is Shakti or power. Shiva is the destroyer, the most powerful god of Hindu pantheon and one of the godheads in Hindu trinity, along with Brahma and Vishnu. As recognition of this fact, Hindus isolate his shrine separate from those of other deities in the temple. According to the Shaivism sect, the highest form of Shiva is formless, limitless, transcendent, and unchanging absolute Brahman, and the primal Atman or soul of the universe. As a complex character, he usually represents goodness, benevolence, and serves as the protector. But he also has a darker side as the leader of evil spirits, ghosts, and vampires, and as the master of thieves, villains, and beggars. He is also associated with time, and particularly as the destroyer of all things. Shiva is also the great ascetic, abstaining from all forms of indulgence and pleasure, concentrating rather on meditation as a means to find perfect happiness. Nobody knows who the father and mother of Lord Shiva are. He is said to live in Mount Kailasha with his wife Devi Parvati. His main weapon is trident or trishul, Pashupatastra and Pinakadhanush. His main mode of transportation is Nandi, the bull. He is usually symbolized by the lingam. He has two sons named Ganesha and Kartikeya. Both sons are very powerful and popular deities in Hinduism, especially Lord Ganesha, who is worshipped first before starting the worship of any other god. Shiva, the liberator and provider of ultimate salvation to anyone, is represented by a divine mantra which is pronounced as Om Namah Shivaya. The iconographical attributes of Shiva are the serpent around his neck, the adorning crescent moon, the holy river Ganga flowing from his matted hair, the third eye on his forehead, the trishula or trident as his weapon, and the damaru drum. He is usually worshipped in the iconic form of lingam. Shiva is a pan-Hindu deity revered widely by Hindus in India, Nepal, and Sri Lanka. He has already taken a lot of forms or avatars in the earth, among which the major avatars are Pipalad, Nandi, Birbhadra, Bhairava, Aswatthama, Sharava, Grihapati, Durvasa, Hanuman, Rishabh, Yatinath, Shureshwar, Yakshashwar, and Avalokiteshowra. These avatars are highly revered in Hinduism and are worshipped with utmost devotion. Followers of Shaivism, called Shaivas, revere Shiva as the supreme being. Shaivism is one of the four major sects of Hinduism, the other being Vaishnavism, Shaktism, and the Smartha tradition. Shaivas believe that Shiva is all and in all, the creator, the preserver, destroyer, revealer, and concealer of all that is. He is the creation that results from him. He is everything and everywhere. Shiva is the primal soul, the pure consciousness, and absolute reality in the Shaiva traditions. There are a lot of interesting stories on adventure and deeds of Lord Shiva, of which Hindu people keep on passing them from generations over generations. One of the stories goes like this. During the Samudra Manthana, also known as the ocean churning, various types of good and bad things came out from the womb of the ocean. One of the most catastrophic thing that came from the womb of ocean was halahala or kalkut poison. Due to the effect of this very powerful poison, The world was starting to die out at a very rapid rate. And then Lord Shiva rushed into shape the world from destruction by drinking the poison. But he did not swallow the poison and made it stay in his throat. Due to this, his neck turned blue and he is now well known as Nilkanta as well. There are various other stories on Lord Shiva, while we will be uploading such videos in this channel very soon. Shiva's main role is to provide salvation to living organisms. He is also known as Mahakal, the death of the dead. Shiva and Vishnu are the only gods in Hinduism that can provide true death or salvation or mokshya. In Buddhism, mokshya is also known as Nirvana. The purpose of most of the avatars of Lord Shiva on earth were meant to provide the true salvation or mokshya to humans. Thus, he is said to be still alive in various forms like Hanuman and Avalokiteshowra, who will remain till the end of the time, until when every soul in the earth receives true salvation. This is all for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to like and subscribe this channel to enjoy more videos like this. And I hope to see you guys in the next video.